So, after some hilarious antics, we did not get everybody in the draft. Took quite a while. Looks like there is seven of us, not counting. We didn't make it. Oh, Finkel. Finkel did not make the draft. Instead, we have Starbells. So I'm not sure if this is gonna go through, but I'm gonna record anyway, just in case it does. As far as this pack is concerned, it's pretty easy. There's a skin render, and he's just nuts. Slicing Twain's awesome, but I like skin render a little bit better. It's my kind of two for one. Painsmith should go pretty early too, which is kind of a bummer, but not much you can do there. Other cards of note are Chemist Skyguard and Origin Spellbomb. But I'm gonna take a skin render, and then I'm gonna pause this really quick and go jump on aim to see what the deal is. All right, next pack's up. Nothing very exciting here. I could force the archetype I wrote about a couple weeks ago, that black-red archetype, but I don't know if that is a smart move. There just really isn't any card here that's exciting. I mean, Sky Eel School's the best. If I was to go that archetype, I would take a Dross Hopper or Instill Infection. Instill Infection's a little even expensive. You really don't want to be running in that deck. That said, guess I'm just gonna go with the school for now. Nah, I'm gonna go with the Dross Hopper. Not gonna force the archetype, but I don't think I'm losing out on much by taking the Hopper over the school, and we'll see how it works out. There is a Mirror Smith in this pack. That's really it. There's, if I wanted to stay in this archetype, I could take a Faerevor, but he'll table. And Liquid Metal Coating's fine. There's really just not that much in this pack, so I'm just gonna take the Mirror Smith and see what we get next pack. Alright, well, that's a good sign. Dispense Justice is not amazing, but it's decent. It's not as good as some other removal spells in the format, but I would gladly take it. You have to take an artifact, so we're gonna have to keep that in mind. We just had some pretty bad artifacts so far, a couple Culling Dais and some spell bombs and stuff. But we're gonna take a Dispense Justice. Okay, this pack's got a bunch of unplayables and then two green mana fixers, basically. Again, I don't really see a reason to force that one archetype, the red-black aggro archetype. Otherwise, I would take like a Goblin Gavalier here. But Copper Mirror and Horizon Spellbomb are both fine. I'm gonna go ahead and take the Mirror just because he is more likely to make the deck if he is off color. Or we could end up green, or you know, any situation might happen. Really haven't seen any black. I mean, we took a Dross Hopper, but that doesn't really count. So the other option would be a Snapsail Glider, but the Mirror is probably just better. Taking our time here. I'm not sure. Everybody's talking. We should have seven videos up with this, so everybody's kind of letting everyone know about their packs. So it's going to take a little bit longer than a normal draft. As far as what Starbells is doing, I can't quite answer that. But for anyone not familiar, we have Steve, Omani Schwartz, Chris Pakula, Tom Martell, Brad Nelson, Josh Ottolayton, Luis Scott Vargas, and myself as the seven that made it in. So these packs just are pretty weak. I mean, I got those white cards, but they're quickly, that is becoming a pipe dream. I could take a Care Pass Forger here, which is the best card, or I could just move back in and try to take some cards for the archetype that I was trying to go. I only have two cards for it right now, but I mean, if nothing's gonna come, I don't know what else I can do. Care Pass Forger seems like a weak card to move into, but it's also the best card in the pack. I'm gonna take this Daredevil. Not trying to force here, but the card quality is just so weak that I gotta move into some archetype. And if I throw away, you know, three picks to do it, then so be it. I don't think anybody else is gonna necessarily go into that archetype just because it's pretty bad. And hopefully I'll table some stuff like the Faerevor and Goblin Gavalier and stuff like that. And again, if this card doesn't, if I end up getting some insane card this pack, then I'll just abort. But I didn't. I got an Untamed Might's the best card. Trinket Mage is good too, but Sovok Lifestaff goes in pretty much any deck, including the one that I'm trying to draft. So let's go ahead and take that. Again, these packs have not been super exciting, so, you know, we just gotta make the best of it. So anyway, if we do end up in the red-black aggro deck, we're looking to play 15 lands, sometimes 14, sometimes 16, but 15 is really where we're at. Two drops, these guys are all-stars in the deck. They're obviously not, like, good on their own, but just in the deck you just need Goblin Pikers. And Skin Render is one of the few cards I'd play that costs 4. Sobok Lifestaff's good, makes your Goblin Gavalier and your Fume Spitter's good. This Mirrorsmith and Dispense Justice over here, I mean, we could still end up playing them. So hopefully we'll just start picking up good artifacts and leave our options open. But the one thing about the red-black aggro deck is it only plays, you know, 8 to 10 artifacts. So it really only wants, like, Panic Spell Bombs, Lifestaffs, Necrogen Sensors, which there was a couple of, so maybe I'll table some Necrogen Sensors. Nothing really in this pack either. There is a Flesh Allergy, which is one of the few 4-drops I would consider playing. Leonin Arbiter is not very good. Nothing too exciting here, so I'm just going to go ahead and take the Flesh Allergy. There was a Poison Guy, a big Alpha Tyrannax. I mean, green's kind of open, but the problem with green is you end up with these split packs where you have, you know, your Alpha Tyrannax and your Poison Guy, and you have to choose which one you want to go into. But this is a good sign. We tabled a Necrogen Sensor, so we're just going to stay on track with that pack, with that theme for these packs, because I remember how weak they were, and hopefully we'll just pick up some of these cards that nobody else wants and be able to move in. Right now, with 2 4-drops, we'd probably end up playing 16 lands, which is fine since we missed so many early picks, but, you know, could be made up for in the next couple packs. And I'm not against trying to do the same thing with the black-white deck if the red stops coming. Mirrorsmith is obviously one of the better aggro cards in white. Glint Hawk is another good one. And then Dispense Justice is fine as removal. But, yeah, these packs have been overall pretty weak. I mean, Skin Render, Dispense Justice, and Mirrorsmith are all good. Everything else we have is kind of blasé. Ikarat's tabled, and as did Sky Eel School. And those are the only 2 cards I was even considering. So that's kind of strange. I mean, I'm going to take the school because it's the best card at this point. And pass all the rest of this junk. I guess Ikarat's is kind of scary. I'll take the Ikarat's. It cuts black, and hopefully somebody doesn't get the impression that Poison's open because of a 10th pick Ikarat's or whatever. Kuldalth Rebirth, not the 1-drop you want, but I'll take it. Better than nothing. And we'll get 2 of them, I guess. And this card I haven't actually played in this deck. Could be good. I don't know. We'll take it. We'll take a crappy Golden Urn. I don't like to hide cards yet. I mean, I'll hide this Ikarat's, but that's basically it. And a land, of course. But all these are at least fringe playable at some point. We're just going to try to snap up some aggro guys. I feel like somebody might have moved into our archetype. I don't know how many people read my articles that are in this draft. I know, like, probably Martel does, maybe Luis. But I'm guessing that they're not just going to try an article or a strategy out blind, so. But the fact that, like, Ferivore was gone, Goblin Gavalier was gone, those kind of things worry me a little bit. This pack is better than pretty much every pack we had before. So there's a Arc Trail, which is really good. We can probably table this Daredevil or this Replica. There's also a Grasp in Darkness. But that's not nearly as good as Arc Trail is. It is black, is the one thing to keep in mind. I'm not even going to look at Edge Champion. He's just a Gray Ogre. He's not that exciting. So the cards we would like to get back: Volshock Replica, Oxo Daredevil, Tumble Magnet, Grasp in Darkness, and Arc Trail are really the cards that we would like out of this pack, and we'll take Edge Champion if it comes. Grasp is good, but if we're going to end up in the deck that I would like to end up in, we really want this Arc Trail. It's just the best. So I think we're going to take this and move in a little bit, and it was a pretty pivotal pick just because we're want to play Skin Render for sure, so Grasp is a little more appealing. But Arc Trail's more powerful, so I just had to give the nod to it. I am going to go ahead and hide this Golden Urn. Alright, so we have another Daredevil, a Moriarch replica, Razor Hippogriff if we want to go into white still. I mean, that's the best card, probably. Then there's a Genesis Wave, which is also good. Feels so weird taking these bad cards, but at the same time, we have to pick an archetype, so I'm going to go with the Daredevil, and you just kind of got to knuckle down and just go with your gut and start taking something eventually. So I'm going to go with this Daredevil, and, you know, passing the Hippogriff kind of sucks, but whatever. Again, I don't know about Assault Strobe. I'll look at it later. I'm not sure if it's going to be very good. Flesh Allergies, probably going to be pretty good in this deck. Looks like we'll be 16 lands. We definitely want some one drops, some Fume Spitters, some Goblin Cavaliers. We got two Rebirths, which are kind of like one drops, but you really need something to go with them. What do we have here? We have nothing. Awesome. This is, we're getting thrown for loops here, and it kind of sucks. If we had taken the 3-2 flyer, we'd have a rest, which might just be our pick anyway. Because there's nothing here besides a Volshock Heartstoker. But maybe we just want to go with that. Give us a 3-drop. It's way weaker than everything else here, but no reason to keep bouncing back and forth. You kind of just have to, if nothing else, regardless of how our deck turns out, we just have to, this is like a lesson in knowing when you're in deep and just going with it. And I'm just going to take this Heartstoker, and we'll see how it works out. We definitely need some help. There's a Fume Spitter, so that's good. There's also Blister Grub, which our deck would like. This Mirror Reservoir is pretty late, especially with the Galvanizer going before it. White's so open, we could have been white, but it just wasn't coming pack one. I guess it wouldn't be coming pack three either. We got these two cards, and that was it. But Fume Spitter is a good pickup. Just having another guy, especially one that works with Flesh Allergy, gets in early damage. And we need some artifacts. It's really my priority now. Panic Spell Bomb being the most important one. But also Furnace Celebration would be awesome at this point. So hopefully we can get that. Good. These are so bad. We're just getting absolutely nothing. We could play Oriok Replica, but that just seems really awkward. So instead, I'm going to take Instill Infection. Foil one, because it doesn't matter, because I don't care about that signal. Our deck looks pretty bad right now. I'm a little bummed out, but the good thing about this deck is you get a lot of late picks that make it good, so I'm going to go ahead and hide these. I'm going to hide this Copper Mirror since we don't want to play it. No artifacts. Do a cost sort. Don't think we're going to play this Assault Strobe, but we might. Alright, what do we got here? We have Fair of War, which is a good one. Although we are short on artifacts for it, we can probably pick those up later. A Quarter Shield's the only other card I would even consider here, and it's not very good, so. We're only at 7 creatures, too. We have 2 Rebirths, which are kind of like creatures. But we definitely need to pick up more guys. We want kind of like 14 guys. Hopefully we table one of the Daredevils. The one that was in our first pack that we took Arc Trail over. And definitely want some more Necrogen Sensors, Tumble Magnets, Panic Spell Bombs, any type of equipment that boosts power. Infiltration Lens is okay. I'll take it. We have quite a few guys. I mean, it's not my favorite equipment in this deck, but we will draw some cards off it, and that's good enough for me. It's going to be better than Blister Grub since we just picked up 2-3 drops. Blister Grub's a fine card, but we could pick more of him up later. We just need another artifact, though. Especially a 1-drop to trigger our... I'm going to go ahead and hide this Assault Strobe. If we get, you know, something crazy, I'll bring it back up later.